And we're talking school funding. Is that something that's on your radar? And what do you have planned, if anything?
Absolutely. In fact, I've been meeting with the various groups in Jersey City, some of the Board of Education members, to really look and see where we can help them to bring more money in. John, the way that money's being taken away right now is unfair. I realize Jersey City has seen a lot of growth, but it's going to take time. I think you can't just cut them the way they've been cut. They need to be weaned little by little. You can't hit people with massive tax increases. It's never a good time to have a tax increase, John, but this would definitely be the wrong time. When you look at the numbers, you're reading those numbers I'm reading. It's impossible. So definitely we have a lot of meetings set up with the governor, with the DOE, to help Jersey City with that. I'm committed to that. So is Annette and Raj. We all have to recognize our neighbors, and I think Hoboken has to do that. I think some of the council members realize that in Hoboken. Maybe the councilwoman doesn't agree with us on that. I just think blocking the views along the Palisades is the wrong thing to do. I think Hoboken's residents are not looking for gigantic buildings. They did surveys in the past in Hoboken. I think the average survey was saying they were looking at a 6 or a 7-story building. Hoboken's very congested. I'm not interfering in Hoboken's business, but I also have to protect the interest of everyone from Jersey City all the way up to Englewood Cliffs. The Palisades is something I think that the views of the Palisades we have to preserve. And that's something we're looking to work together on. We have a piece of legislation in. We're dropping another piece of legislation, possibly to create something similar to the Highlands Commission, where there's going to be a board, and they'll judge some of these applications as they come in. It won't be one swoop, one remedy that will take away Hoboken's ability to build. We're not looking to do it at all. We're just looking to say, look, recognize your neighbor.
So what do you think about this effort to get rid of the line? People talking about fair elections, fair ballots. Any take on that?
It's a good question, John. You know, I thought a lot about it. I know most elected officials will duck the question. I thought a lot about it. I think the line is wherever the mayors in that legislative district are is really what sets the line. I'm not really a concerned person about whether I'm on the line, off the line. I know people put a lot of emphasis into that. I think, John, if you're doing a good job, if you're doing a decent job, if you have the trust of the people, they'll find you no matter where you are. I would be a person that really, I don't have any issue with that whatsoever. I know that there's a big issue in New Jersey with the progressives about the line. Look, wherever I am on the ballot, I'm going to make sure I educate people. That's where I am. And if they want you, they'll find you. I think there's too much emphasis put on the line. I really do. I mean, look, like you mentioned it, I ran off the line in 07. They spent probably 4 times as much as I did at the time. We were victorious. And you know what? I just don't put that major emphasis like many other people do in the line. Whatever happens with that, I'll abide by it and I'll live by it. It's not going to do or die for an elected official. I think too much is put into that.